Welcome to Stayf Draws. I'm Stayf, an illustrator and animator. Now I just released an ebook which is called Little Angel, and it's an ebook available on iBooks, and it also includes the movie because I animated the picture book as well. And in this video I'm going to explain how I made the animation of the original illustrations of Little Angel. So let's get to the video. Now I have imported the file from Procreate, and I painted this entire painting in Procreate. But unfortunately, I merged everything down except for the shading. So all the background and the characters were drawn and painted on one layer. So what I'm now doing is I'm selecting the man in the front and duplicated in a separate layer, and I use the green on a separate layer underneath so that I really can see where all the shadows are, and then just delete them or erase them with the eraser tool. And I had the shadows on a separate layer and it was set to multiply, but I needed the shadows on the character of the man as well, so I just selected the man and then merged the shadows of the man onto the layer of the man, because that needs to be separated, because I'm just looking at the scene and just trying to think of what would move and what wouldn't move. So now I'm working on the cat, and I want the cat to move his head up and also wiggle his tail. So I'm first selected the entire cat, and now I'm just erasing everything from the background. And because I did everything on one layer, I just needed to create it or recreate the scene again, because everything that's moving and that's behind it, I have to paint in the style of the illustration. And I'm now doing it in Photoshop, but maybe it would have been better if I did it in Procreate, because in Procreate you have different kinds of brushes, but this also works. And I'm just using a painterly brush, and sometimes I smudge and it's still in a very painterly style, so I would like to keep it in the same style. And for the background of the floor, I'm just duplicating the floor and then adjust it with the selection tool and just duplicate it and then paint over it again, because this is behind the cat. And I'm also using content aware, so because when you have your layer on the background layer, you can use content aware, and then if you delete certain parts of your illustration, it will copy the elements of the rest of the illustration. And sometimes it does a very good job, but sometimes you just need to paint over it again to keep it in the same style. I'm now doing the woman, and the parts that are moving are her arms and her head. So I just copied the background and created a new file in Photoshop and set the background to a background layer, so I can use the content aware and just keep these things separated. I'm just painting over all the things where the animation will be in front, because otherwise you'll get gaps or you see a ghost image, and you don't want that. So now I'm just recreating the background. I'm now back in my original file, and I'm now just duplicated the head of the woman, and I'm doing the same with the arms of the woman. They need to be separated as well, so I'm selecting the upper arms and the lower arms, and they're all going to be created in different layers. So this is the biggest part of doing animations of original illustrations. It is to do the editing of all the different moving parts. And now I'm just working on the upper left arm or upper right arm, if you look it from the character's point of view. And I'm just painting with one of the pencil brushes in Photoshop, and this is Photoshop 2015, I think. It's in the Creative Cloud. And I'm just erasing the rest, and I'm using that green background because it's, you know, then you can better see what you're doing. And sometimes I even make it a black background. So this is all preparation for the PSD file I'm creating to import into Moho, or it used to be called Animate Studio Pro. And in that software, I'm going to do all the animations. And I'm now just testing it out in Photoshop if all the joints are working well. And the head of the woman needs to be on top of her neck, so her neck is not going to move around. So just had to draw the head a little bit longer. And now I'm working on the right arm, and I will make that into one layer, because in Procreate you can set some bones into the character. But I'm not going to use bones for this one, because you can also animate just using pivot points. So it's just checking, you know, if everything looks right, and just trying out the motion in Photoshop before you import everything into Moho. The difficult part with hair is that, you know, sometimes you need to erase some holes, and I'm just now erasing everything, and then I'll paint some stuff over it. And what I sometimes do is to get a perfect selection of a part is first select around the head and then inverse the selection and then delete it. Otherwise you'll get some ghost images around the head, and it will finally show up in the animation. And I'm just now painting out the mouth, and the mouth is going to be in two stages. So it's going to be a closed mouth and an open mouth. And this is the only scene in the Little Angel movie is that there is a dialogue, and this is the mother Little Angel is looking for. And I also want her eyes to blink. So on a separate layer, I'm just painting in the eyelids. Or I'm just selecting the eyelashes. Because when you close your eyes, the eyelashes will move along. So it needs to be in style. So I'm just drawing the closed eyes. And I can animate those in Animate Studio Pro using a switch layer. But I will explain later when I am in Moho. But this is the biggest part of doing original illustrations or an animation of original illustrations, is the preparation. So if your preparation is right, and sometimes you see that there is still something that you didn't erase. So you first need to check everything before you import everything into Moho. And lastly, I just decided that I also wanted to move the head of the cat. And the neck is going to be in front of the head. And this is going to be a very simple illustration or animation of the illustration. So you can import a PSD into Procreate and then choose individually. Then it will create all the layers you have in your PSD. And all these layers you can use to animate. So I'm now just setting up the scene. When you're setting up a file in Moho or Animate Studio Pro, you need to do that on keyframe 0. So I'm now creating a group for the head of the woman. All the layers of the head will be in the same group because I'm going to animate the group. And then after that, you can also animate parts within the group. So for the eyes, I'm creating a switch layer and I just dragged the eye lids into it. And then I create an empty vector layer. So you can switch between the empty vector layer and the closed eyes. And then you can just animate very simply by using the switch layer. You can animate the opening and closing of the eyes. I'm going to do the same with the mouth, because that has two layers in it, a closed mouth and an open mouth. And with that, I'm going to animate the dialogue. The cat is also going to be in a separate layer. And the cat I'm going to set up with some bones into it. And I'm dragging the head to the left so it won't affect the bone strengths of the bones, because you can set the bone strength and you just need to play around with it until you're satisfied. And this is created on keyframe 0, and on keyframe 1 you can set up your character. So you have to drag everything into place, because from keyframe 1 you can animate the entire scene. I just created some little bones into the tail so that I can create, you know, the waving of the tail of the cat. And what I'm now doing is importing the soundtrack. And this was the Dutch soundtrack. And I need that for the dialogue, because then you can animate to the dialogue. Most of the time in animation, the sound is recorded first, and on top of the audio you can animate, especially if someone's talking, you can animate the mouth. First I'm going to make the cat move his tail, and you can do that by just creating some keyframes on the timeline. And the cat also needs to look up in the beginning, because the woman is going to say something. That's why it's also important that you create each character on its own bone layer. Now I'm first animating the bigger parts, and later on you can animate the details like the closing of the eyes and the mouth sync. Now I'm just using the pivot point in Anime Studio Pro or Moho. This is Moho I'm working in. And these are just very simple animations, because I could have done an entire animation of everything, but then it would take me a year to complete. And this is just a different kind of a style of animation. It's a bit limited, but you know, you can still tell a story with simple animations. So now I'm animating the blinking of the eyes. And I'm now animating the mouth, and I just turned down the sound of the voice because I'm just scrubbing back and forth, and then it really sounds terrible. So you just have to look for the pauses, and then you use the closed mouth, and when the character is talking you use the open mouth. And you know, sometimes you have all the vowels you can animate, but this is just as effective, especially for the style of animation I'm doing right now. And when I finished the mouth sync, I'm going to animate the arms of the lady. And she is just rubbing her tummy because she's pregnant. And when you study women, you know, you always see that they're rubbing their belly, because that's a bit of a connection with the child within. And I could have used bones for the arms, but I just wanted to do it quick, because this entire scene I animated in 1.5 hours, and most of the time was spent recreating the file and making the different parts of the body in Photoshop. So the preparation is more work than the actual animation. And it's just refining the animation, because the woman is built up from different parts, and in the middle I also created a file so that the right upper arm would fall behind it. But then you get a little bit in trouble when you animate the hands above that. You can see it disappear behind the belly, so you need to be very minimal into your animations. So sometimes you don't need to be very extreme in your animations. You can keep it very subtle. And the great thing of Moho is that there's a camera, and you can use the camera to create a more dynamic shot. So I've now finished animating this scene in Moho, and then you can render it, but I'm not going to show you because that takes too long. I'm just going to show you the end result. And here's one of the last scenes of Little Angel.
I'm sure. I feel there is a little angel in my tummy. I'm so happy.
I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you like it, please give it a thumbs up or subscribe to my channel. In that way you won't miss a single video. Drawing is fun, and practice makes perfect. See you next time. Doodles!